What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Anime. We gonna switch it up today. We reacting to a... Is your spouse a cheater? You feel what I'm saying? This is my boy, Jack TV. You feel me? Shout out to him. We just gonna do a little reaction. This came out, like, a couple months ago, whatever. But I don't react to stuff like this, so we gonna just see where it goes in the YouTube algorithm. But y'all know what I mean, you know what I'm just... I'm gonna shut up, let y'all enjoy the video, you feel me? Like, comment, subscribe, you dig what I'm saying? Original video will be down in the description. Without further ado, let's get it. Huh? I was a groupie before you met me? Oh!
Truly loyal to him or not. However, I brought out famous YouTuber and TikToker TJ Watkins here to help us figure this out. You're going to be playing role as a decoy in today's.
I'm still shocked off that slap.
Have you done one of these before? Have you ever been on this before?
Nah, I've never did nothing like that before. Okay, this is my first time.
3 weeks ago, a guy named Cam reached out to me on Instagram inquiring about a loyalty test because he felt like his girlfriend's behavior was changing. He explained to me that ever since her rise to fame on social media, she's become more and more addicted to it and she'd do anything for attention. Cam is not really into social media as much. However, he still supports his girlfriend 100%. The only problem is he doesn't like the lengths that she will go to in order to be noticed. So why do
you feel like that's, I'm sorry, bro. Right then and there, if you're not even comfortable with the lengths this girl's gonna go to get noticed with that paper, whatever. Brother. Not all good money. Wait, how'd it go? Not all money is good money. You know what I'm saying?
It's tough, but I say it really started like 2020 when COVID hit. She has real bad asthma. It runs in her family. Her mom got it, sister got it, all of them got it. You feel me? Mm-hmm. So that's when COVID was. That's like COVID at its peak. Everybody.
This alcohol sick. In here, by the way, guys.
I walk into the crib from work, and she unconscious in the bed. So I'm tapping her, trying to get her like to respond. She was not responding. She got cold and everything, so I panicked. So I called an ambulance. So they come in, they rush in, they giving her CPR, mouth to mouth resuscitation, all that.
Okay.
So I'm thinking she dead. Like I don't know what the f going on. So thankfully they rushed her to the hospital. She was in a coma for like 2 weeks, twin. Like, and I'm there every day, right by her side. Like this my girl. So it's like.
Real over look here. At Romeo over here.
So, man, and when she finally got right,
all God, that
she started putting, her, she started
just to fall so short.
Media, like TikTok, Instagram, things like that. She started gaining traction, getting followers, getting clout. And me as a supportive boyfriend, I'm encouraging her, I'm uplifting her, all that. You feel me? Mm-hmm. But then I get a call from my homeboy randomly, and he talking about. Hey, your girl is all in this dude, likes, comments, she tagging this man in videos. Mm. I'm like, what? After we've been through all this, like I thought I watched her die in the room, twin. And she under this nigga comments, under this nigga likes.
Hey, I fought with my boy, but his jacket got so much hair on it. Bro, somebody give my boy a lint roller, please. God, look, maybe 12 dogs in that damn house. He rolling in the ground with the dogs. Oh my gosh, that's funny, bro.
Everything, bro. A TikTok nigga, bro.
He said a TikTok nigga, bro. Oh, what's wrong with the TikTok niggas, bro? Oh, that's a kryptonite. That's why I got the TikTok guy on here. Oh, this is actually hilarious, bro. TikTok nigga, bro.
Yeah. So basically, she's leveling up within the social media game, and she's just
leveling up. She's doing more than that.
Pictures. That's what's going on.
Right. And I'm like, I'm not no social media nigga. I'm low key. Mm-hmm. So I feel like she wants somebody with the influence and the clout. And the look and the clout and shit like that. And that's just not me.
Who exactly is it that she's?
I got this nigga Instagram, bro. This nigga got all these followers and shit, bro.
He got all the hoes.
At this point, I was aware that his girlfriend was in a lot of the likes and comments of this particular person. However, Cam wanted to know if she was left alone in a room with him, would she cheat? But
Hell yeah.
As I said before, he did look familiar to me, but I was not sure how to get in contact with him because I didn't follow him, nor did he follow me, nor did I know anybody who followed him as well. But my friend Key was able to get me in touch with his manager. So from here, after a couple phone calls and emails, we set up a date so we could have TJ play this role as a decoy in our loyalty test.
Why, man, look at his lips in front of our camera. This her?
Hello.
Wait, this the bitch he worried about? Nah, this can't be her, bro. This can't be her, bro. This can't be her,
bro. Hey, boo, I'm just trying to see how far you are.
Hey, girl, I'm like 35 minutes away. I'm on the highway now.
Nah, beginning of the video, different girl.
Okay, babe, call me when you're outside.
The way we were going to get her alone with TJ was simple. We had TJ's manager reach out to Maya in order to get her on her team. Under her management, she promises influencers immediate growth and collabs with bigger influencers. So to Maya, there was literally no reason for her not to accept this. So from here, the plan...
Wait. They're going to blur her face. Let me see what she look like. Hold on.
No reason.
That's what she look like? She mid too.
Not to accept this. So from here, the plan was to set up a meet and greet event at TJ's manager's apartment.
All right, so this right here is the control room. This is where you're going to be listening in on everything. Right here is
control room. I guess a table and a laptop.
So I don't have it connected yet, but it will be there so you can see where
my man said the control room.
Is there any questions you got for us?
I ain't get one of them shirts.
Brother, you asking all the wrong stupid shit. Any more questions, I'm like, do you have 911 on speed dial? Because I find this girl cheating on me, bro. Ain't going to say no more.
Yeah, if you want.
For sure. Y'all need, like, y'all probably got damn temptations and shit.
At this point, it had been 2 weeks since we initially set up this loyalty.
How you trying to be like him? He said he don't even mess with the social media.
Hello. Yeah, you can just park in the parking garage. We plan to come down and get
you. At this point, Maya has arrived and everything was going to plan.
Look. This is the apartment.
From here, we had TJ's manager have a casual conversation with them just so we could make this scene seem as realistic as possible.
Okay. And this is my influencer, TJ. Hey, TJ Maya, TJ.
Nice to meet you.
Get well acquainted. You see.
She is already ahead of you.
I got a couple other influencers, but like this is who I'm mainly working with at the moment. So pretty much I brought her here today so y'all could like talk about a few like collabs for future reference.
Mm-hmm.
But so pretty much I manage TJ. He's one of the guys that I manage. But what comes with managing influencers is to get them to a bigger goal. Like you want all influencers to get brand deals. You want them to start making the real, real money. Like people paying them crazy amounts to just post videos and sounds on TikToks and stuff.
Yeah. Like the influencer industry by itself is like, it's something like a lot of people try to get into, but some people can't get into it.
A lot of people.
The influencer industry, like, is like, it's lit for real, because like, it sets you up for a lot of stuff. Like she said, brand deals, it gets you like the following, you feel me? Like, and from the following, like, they gonna support you with whatever. Like, whatever you decide to do, they gonna fully support you.
Exactly, bro. So if y'all really... I think with anime, bro. Support this video. Hit the subscribe button. You know what I'm saying?
You feel me? On top of that, like, you doing what you love. Like, you just outside living, recording your life, or doing whatever. Like, you know what I'm saying? And posting pictures, getting paid for that. So I feel like you would like it, for real.
What
do
you think?
I feel like I would like it, so I'll be able to collab, like, big creators like you.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Because I don't already see some of your videos.
Oh, for real?
I be tapping in, yeah.
You be tapping in?
Yeah.
That shit's smooth, man.
That's perfect. Y'all already acquainted.
She already got nigga DMs.
We could work some.
Yeah. After a few more minutes of small talk, it was time for TJ's manager to make an excuse to leave.
Okay, so I do actually have a couple other influencers that's coming here so you can meet them and collab with them. But one of my influencers is having car trouble, so I am going to have to go get them. But if y'all have any questions or y'all need any guidance on like which way to do the videos or anything, just call me.
Okay,
you got my
cool.
number.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, cool?
So you're
yeah.
meeting?
Yeah, I believe.
Okay.
But y'all gonna be straight.
Yeah, you gonna
just
be
call
smooth,
me if you
man.
Need me.
You gonna be smooth.
You're in good hands, I promise. Okay?
For sure.
It was nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too, girl.
Be safe.
Alright, you be safe too. And what you say your name was again?
I feel like it's my bitch. I'm like, hold on, what you about to do?
TikTok, as you know what I'm saying, like.
Yeah, I already know who you are. You don't follow me back though. You're a little Hollywood actor.
What you mean? I have 350,000 people. On my Instagram, I follow you. I know he's trying to spit game, but it's just so funny to me, bro. Cause she lying, gang.
I don't really check my requests for real. Like, I don't really be into all that for real. Like, you feel me? If I would have seen it, though, I promise I would hit you back. Like, you seen like a little piece that I could vibe with on shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real.
You think you can vibe with me?
Yeah, for sure. You look like somebody I could vibe with. I gotta get to know you for real, though. You feel me? Like, to see what your vibes be like. And if our vibes match, then for sure.
Well, I already know you
because
I be watching you.
So that's what I'm saying.
So you saw my boy's face. You can't do this. Look at my boy's face.
You feel me? Like, to see what your vibes.
Look at his face.
Our vibes match, then, for sure.
Well, your vibe. He said, no.
That's what you say, though. I can see that for myself. That's what I'm saying. You know? Like, you can say we match all day, but I got to really see that.
TJ, stop, man. You talking to me?
How you feel about like the whole TikTok relationship? Like, you f*** with that or you don't?
I mean, I f*** with it. It's just that I don't really have nobody to for real do it with, because.
So how you feel about me and you doing it? Like, you feel like that'd be something you could, like.
You know, I definitely do it with you. You know, I don't care if it's fake, real, anything with TJ. I don't give a f***.
So you feel like it could go from being just content to like an actual real thing, though?
I mean, yeah, because I've been watching you. I've been you.
I can't.
So you ain't got like no boyfriend in there. Like, oh. I mean, you feel me? Like,
my man TJW just was asking that. You know what I'm saying? My man TJW. Thank you, TJ. But we going to see what she say. We already know the answer.
And they're like, oh, you feel me? Like, I don't want
I'm
nobody trying to beat up.
I'm single as f-. I don't have no nigga. None of that, like,
So how long you been single for?
I've been single for about 3 years.
3 years? Like, damn, 3 years is a long time.
It's a
like,
long time.
Bruh. The extent people go just to get some dick, bruh. I know she came for other reasons too, like a collab and et cetera, but the extent people go, that's crazy.
You more with like focusing on yourself or something.
Nah, I don't fuck with these niggas. I don't fuck with them. They don't fuck with me. So I just really just zoned in on my
content. She locked in on her content.
Somebody like, we doing content. We doing everything we need to do together.
Okay.
We're growing.
I ain't gonna count though.
Growing. Yeah. They love that word. Grow together.
Yeah.
Somebody, TJ didn't do that, bro. He fouled for that one. He didn't know how to do that, bro. I ain't gonna lie. I promise you right now, homeboy is storming down there right now. I promise you.
That motherfucker backed up for sure.
He said that bitch backed up for sure. Nah, bro, this shit is funny, bro. Look at his face. Look at his face, bruh. He forgot it was a video, a setup.
You play too much.
Nah, that motherfucker fat. Oh, good. That bitch fat.
Now her moving close. Nah, I'm done. Running back. Yeah, run the whole thing right back right now.
Yeah. That motherfucker fat, though, for sure.
For sure.
You play too much.
Nah, that motherfucker fat. Oh, good. That bitch fat.
Ain't no way.
Yeah, for shit,
so. So, what's up? Like, who you talk to?
I currently don't talk to nobody right now. I ain't gonna count. Like, it's I'm in a drought or something. Like,
there ain't no damn okay. Drought.
I don't care if you lie or you is, but you just need to make sure that I'm not.
Wait. What did she just say? She doesn't care? What? Bruh, I can't, bruh. I'm telling you, bruh, doing videos drunk, bruh, is so funny. You going back, bruh. What'd she say?
So, what's up? Like, who you talk to?
I don't talk to nobody, Shotty.
I don't talk to nobody right now. I ain't gonna care.
I'm in a drought.
I'm in a drought.
What'd she say?
You feel me?
Okay, well, I don't care if you lying or if you is, but you just need to make sure the hoes is gone, because I'm not playing none of that.
Sorry, I can't.
Them to get beat up right now.
Damn, already?
Yes, already. One second in, like, they can get beat up.
I don't even know you.
TJ. Ben looking at you.
Ben looking at me.
Ben.
I'm saying, so what? Oh, what
we
about
saw
me?
We saw her face.
Like, I mean, you know what you do. You make your videos, you watch them with your little hair, your hair.
You know, bitch, don't touch my hair, bro.
Guys, it is debatable whether or not you guys want to say Maya failed or not, because she could have been doing all of this just to boost her career. But I'll leave that to you guys in the comments, so go ahead and
comment. Bro, my man, if she just wanted to boost her career, she wouldn't be twerking in front of the man. I get it. The manager set her up there. Like, so she believes that she's going to get some type of promotion, etc., collab. It's already set deal. You see what I'm saying? She don't need to do anything else. She wanted more than that.
Comment your opinion on this. Let me know. However, TJ did something a little bit off script that shocked me. He offered her a featured post on his TikTok page that would, of course, get her more attention. But the challenge that he offered her to do was pretty wild.
Like, we can go ahead and collab.
Why
like,
is Mike so low?
Emotion for if you down for real. Like, I got a little TikTok that we could do. You feel me? Like, I put that bit in my draft. So I drop it in my whichever one you cool with.
You gotta drop it.
TJ so dropping that. his own promotion.
TikTok right now. Drop it today.
You can drop it today. I don't give a
fuck. Yeah, and you ain't gonna get in trouble by nobody.
Why would I get in trouble? I'm a grown ass woman. I can do
that. What they all say, man. That's what y'all say. Then I drop this TikTok. You gonna be getting cussed out. You probably getting beat up. All kind of shit.
That won't matter, though. Even if
it don't matter.
It don't matter. The black eye don't matter, baby. Sweetheart, I want that TikTok. I'm telling you, bro. Social standards and social media got this generation on a hook, boy. She don't care if she get beat up for it.
I don't care.
All right, cool. It sounds good. I
don't
care.
So
we can go ahead and do it now if you want to. Want to go ahead and do it now?
Yeah.
All right, bitch. So let's go ahead and do it. Yeah, that one off the door for putting on 10
seconds. Oh, not this one. Nah, y'all got it, bro. Y'all niggas got it. I ain't got nothing to say, bro. Y'all niggas got it, bro. Let's continue, bro. We already know she a hoe, bro.
Bro, ain't no
They put the Patreon on the video so they can get money. That means she was doing more than what the video is showing right here. Look at this man, TJ. Brother, he's catching hands with me. He did not need to do all this.
Bruh, ain't no fucking way, bruh. Ain't no fucking way, bruh. Ain't no way she doing this shit to me, bruh. I held that down, bruh. All that shit, bruh, since COVID.
Since COVID.
We finna... Hell no, nah, nigga. We finna goddamn...
The prayer. The prayer. You praying. Let's see it. Yo. Time out. What just happened there? Did this man just throw a water bottle at her while she's twerking? And is this man TJ the helper smacking her ass? DJ, you gonna see me, bruh.
What the f*** are you doing?
I'm making content.
What the f*** kind of content this is? This is not what the f*** we discussed you was
what
doing.
What you doing here?
What you mean? What are you ass out?
You set me up?
That don't mean s***. What the, why you got your ass up?
So
this
you set me up?
All the s*** I did for you, all that s*** with COVID, you finna die.
What did you f***?
Oh, you was finna, bro, yo, family.
He loved COVID.
It was just
really
me.
Do?
He had no
what
money.
What did you really do? Buy a couple suits, bitch? What the f*** is that, bitch?
What you mean? I held you down. You had no f***.
fucking money.
What the fuck is food? You think you doing some because you buy food? It's niggas as you see gonna do way more than
I
that.
I ain't hear nothing talking about. This nigga don't even follow you. You a groupie. You don't understand that. Get that to your thick ass school.
Wait. Hold on. What'd she say? Go back.
I ain't follow you. You a groupie. You don't understand that. Get that to your thick ass school.
I was a groupie till he met me.
I just woke up Chris Breezy. That's what I'm gonna do. What you mean why I'm setting you up, bruh?
Your boyfriend put you here today for a loyalty test. He wanted to see whether or not you were gonna cheat on him for this famous guy, this TikToker right here. This guy
is not going
to collab with you. You guys are never going to collab a day in your life. Right now you're being
They already did, technically.
Bose, you're a soulless cheater.
What is broke nigga behavior? Who the fuck goes through all this just to catch somebody?
Broke nigga behavior is crazy.
For no sassy gay ass.
Nigga with them strong ass.
Fuck
you.
Fuck you. Fuck y'all niggas. I get money. Fuck you.
Fuck you. And them strong ass feet.
Strong ass feet.
Soulless cheaters. If you or anybody you know wants to be placed on the loyalty test, feel free to DM me on Instagram at SoulessJ. Thank you guys so much for watching this anyways, though. I really appreciate you guys. Please feel
That's
free
crazy.
To like on this video because I am trying to get security in my budget. I don't want to keep having to deal with these crazy situations all by myself, bro. But
hey, support the man, bro. He ain't trying to get stabbed up. He needs security. And he need to pay them niggas. Support the man. But without further ado, we know how that went down. You dig what I'm saying? It's your boy Anime. Drop the like. Drop the sub. You dig what I'm saying? Anime love y'all. Without further ado, I'ma see y'all boys in the next one. Oh, and ladies, I'ma see y'all in the next one. You know I've been sitting there. Watermelon. But peace.